Hello, creatives. I was looking through this old refurbished book of mine. This was an old book that I got at a tag sale, and I have transformed it into an art journal. And I found this spread, Hard Times. And I thought it was so descriptive of what so many people are going through right now. This is my downstairs, my temporary downstairs studio. The first project that I did on this video, I was still in the studio. So I was upstairs, and it was before we realized how bad the mold test had come out. So we're in the middle of this really chaotic battle with the insurance company and inspectors and mold tests, two different mold test companies that are having radically different answers. So it's, yeah, I'm really relating to this spread. Yeah, a little stressed. Anyways, I can't thank you guys enough for your supportive, loving comments. And I know that so many people are going through difficult times. And my heart goes out to all of you. And let's just hope for some cheerier times ahead, and thank God that we have art to get us through. So anyways, I did the first part of the video was, here, maybe I'll flip this camera around to show you when I do that. Okay, gonna handhold this, so I hope it doesn't get too jiggy jaggy, but the first part is the tissue paper. And that I did while I was still upstairs in the studio. It's actually deli paper. I keep calling it tissue paper. This was such a fun project. And I hope you enjoy watching that. And then the second thing that I did on this video is in this repurposed book, which is this spread. And what I did, the outline, this was so meditative. This was on a day when I completely did not feel like creating. I just literally did not think that I could create at all. So De La Roni has sent me some of their System 3. I think I talk about this later on in the video, but these little fluid paints with, and they have little tiny adapters on them, and you can sort of draw lines with them. So I sort of started out with this abstract thing and then really got into just coloring it in. I used ink tents, neo colors, and different combinations of matte medium and gesso. This was the backgrounds done with a Liquitex marker. I do a sped up version of it later in the video to music, but this was really meditative. It really helped sort of settle my nervous system a little bit from the stress, as was this. This making these was a little more active, and I ended up getting really sick in the studio by the time I got to the last one. So I sort of end that session abruptly, and the last one didn't get too much on it, but it was a fun project to do. So those two projects are in this one. And then next week, maybe I'll talk about this that I was doing, these little thumbnail sketches. So pretty down here in this temporary studio, I'm kind of staying abstract and loose. And just trying to stay creative with super low energy. You know, it's got a nice view of outside into the woods, which is nice. So that's what I'm up to. So I hope you enjoy the video, and please do remember, if you enjoy the video, to give it a thumbs up and to subscribe, and also to share the video with friends. It really does help me if you give the thumbs up and watch the videos through and share them. Okay, guys, so I hope you enjoy the video, and I will see you in the next video. Continuing on in the vein of using up sort of leftover materials that I have in the studio, like these jars with just very small amounts of paint in them, and some are dried up. I used to use these a lot when I did abstract work and mixed media work in my art journals, and I really liked them. But then I got more into mixing my own colors, so they got put away, and like I said, many of them have dried out. So I did those couple of mixed media paintings recently where I just got out like my Inktense pencils and some, you know, some art supplies that are tucked away that I haven't been using that much. So I think I am going to continue on in that frame of mind. I'm going to pick through those, pick out some colors that are not dried up. I also have tons of this deli paper, and I occasionally use it for collage. I used to use it for jelly printing a lot. I've gotten so far away from mixed media work, so I'm going to use some of this. And I thought, let's see, maybe I will use some of my Liquitex pens. I've got some Posca markers. Ooh, this might be fun. The Art Graph. I haven't used these in a long time. Okay, so I'll grab those out. Love this big fat piece of charcoal, but I do use that rather frequently. I use my gouache a lot. Ooh, maybe these. Yeah. Some Neo colors, possibly. I don't use those that much anymore. Okay, what else don't I use that much of? Don't use... Ooh, I never use this stuff. I actually never use this stuff. So this I'll get out. Probably getting too much stuff out, but I'll take this and maybe some of these. I'm probably going to overwhelm myself by taking out too much stuff. Okay, and there's one more, two more draws. I might take out some of these inks too. Not sure yet. Ooh. Yeah, I used to paint with watercolors a lot, and I don't anymore. I think I will grab some watercolors. All right, I grabbed some Neo Color crayons. These are Neo Color 2s, so they're the water soluble. Some of these old ink things that may be dried out, and some, I think this is Mission Gold watercolors, and some scrapers, some golden high flow acrylics, and a very odd assortment of colors. I think this came as a set, and it was like such a weird assortment of colors that I never really used it. So I've got those and my tissue paper. So I'm going to set up the camera and just do a few of these to get started and see how it feels. Okay, so I grabbed a couple of more things. I grabbed a Graph Tint Lyra, and this is the non-water soluble one. So this will not dissolve in water. I grabbed some China markers. And white, blue, and red. I think this is also a, yeah, this is a non-water soluble in a 9B, and I think that's a 2B. Then I grabbed a water soluble one, Derwent. And oh yeah, this is another China marker in black. So there's all kinds of stuff. And I'm just going to try to go kind of intuitively, use a couple of the items on each paper that I do, and just see what happens. Just have a little fun. Posey, are you going to pant the whole time I'm making a video? Okay, and since these papers will just be used for collage on other mixed media pieces, it doesn't really matter what I start with or what I use. So some of these watercolors are Mission Gold. Are they all Mission Gold? No, there's some Core in here. I can see some, yeah, some of Golden's Core. So let me just grab some colors and see what happens. There's barely any in some of these, so I don't know if they'll be dried up. Okay, use these for a start. Do is I'm going to start by spraying the paper. Bright flash by the street lights. Keep waiting till you've arrived. Let it unfold. Let it unfold. Give me reason to feel right. I keep waiting for the morning light. I let him fall. Let him.
from a cloud above. So bright I can see the lights taking you up and above the blue sky. Tastes good to be drinking all of the honey sweet brew of ours. Up, up in a painted cup, right in the sky like a firefly. Like a firefly. I believe to believe is to feel the fire grow within. I believe to believe is to see how the present comes from dreams. Up, up, up in a painted cup, I will paraglide across the sky. Let flowers and tiny hearts shape in a line in the cup of ours. So sweet like a honeybee can buzz around a honey tree. Up, up in a painted cup, right in the sky like a firefly. Like a firefly. I believe to believe is to feel the fire grow within. I believe.
Okay, so this is what I ended up with. Some mediums were more successful than others, but it was a whole lot of fun. And this was just going to be so much fun to play with as collage paper. It's nice and thin, so it will glue down easily. I like that this one still has transparent areas on it. More earthy tones. This one doesn't have a whole lot on it because I actually started to feel really unwell. So I kind of quit in the middle of this. And even though it is only 7:45, I am off to bed. But I wanted to get a little bit of play done in the studio before I went to bed. So there's that. Made some fun collage pieces with deli paper. It was just so much fun seeing how each different medium that I put on the deli paper reacted to that sort of waxy surface. The clear gesso and white gesso helped everything sort of stick. Love some of these textures that I got. These are just going to be so much fun to use as collage papers. One has more earthy tones on it. It's got some graphite and some wax, some China marker wax crayon. Use the scrapers to make unique marks. And this one didn't get a whole lot of stuff onto it. I'm really happy with the results. These are just going to make really fun collage papers to play with. So this is the stuff that I brought downstairs from my studio since I have been kicked out of my studio because of a mold problem. So I packed up some plastic bins and just brought down all kinds of art supplies, but I especially brought down art supplies that I haven't used in a long time because I think I just am not having an overwhelming urge to create art. I'm pretty tired from this mold stress, so I brought down just all kinds of different things from my draws, ink tents, Stabilos, Neo Colors, some ancient super cheap wax crayons and oil pastels, you know, all kinds of stuff. These are my Liquitex paint markers. Yeah, all kinds of stuff. So, and a bunch of sketchbooks, different sketchbooks. I even actually brought down the Paul Rubens pastels. You know, I figured I could add some of those in as a resist on some mixed media work. So don't really have any plans. You know, I often joke on this channel how I'm methodical, and you know, the truth is I like things the way I like them. I think that kind of goes with the ups and downs of chronic illness that are so out of your control. You never really know when you're going to feel great, and you never really know when you feel awful. So there's a lot of planning and trying to maintain some semblance of control with that. So I feel like getting kicked out of the studio along with feeling so ill from the mold is a little traumatizing. And I really feel like I have to force myself to create a little bit, to sort of create my way through it. And yesterday I absolutely did not feel like creating at all. So this next segment on the video is me sitting down and doing a little bit of videoing for you guys of just a mixed media piece, just, you know, grabbing a few different materials and just hitting the paper with no plan. The interesting thing about it was I sort of fell into this coloring within the lines thing. and it felt very soothing and very relaxing. You know, it sort of takes you back to your childhood coloring. So it actually, once I got going on it, it actually was a good thing. And that is the next segment. I did that piece that you will see next in an old book that I turned into an art journal. So, let's see if I can find the one I did. Where'd it go? There, that's the one that I'm going to show you next, where I just sort of did this, fell into this really meditative coloring. Dale Rowney sent me these fluid acrylics, and I used those on this piece as the outline, and they were really fun to use. I should have put the camera down for this. They're, the black is what I used for the outline. They're fluid paints, and they have a little adapter on them, so you can squeeze the paints out in a linear form, which is what I did when I outlined this piece yesterday. So that's what the next segment is coming up, is just sped up, sort of intuitive, relaxing with some creativity, even though I felt extremely uncreative. I think it's important sometimes to push your way into it, because I did feel better afterwards. So I hope you enjoy the next segment.
someone I'm not really into. Do you need to fix it? Talking bullshit. It's hard to see you when your eyes look dull. Who's gonna save you? Who's gonna make you not blue? Not blue. Blue to bad blue. Sort of witty and jaded, but let's not talk about your coyote song on a rerun. Are you hound dog tired singing all night long? Who's gonna save you? Who's gonna make you? Been one or two since I ran into you. Do you need a picture? Well, that gets old. It's hard to take one when your iPhone's full. Who's gonna save you? Straighten up my bones and be a man.